friends, today we study about how sound is propagated and some characteristics of sound. Compression and rarefaction. When a vibrating object moves forward, it pushes and compresses the air in front of it, creating a region of high pressure. This region is called a compression. This compression starts to move away from the vibrating objects. When the vibrating object moves backwards, it creates a region of low pressure called rarefaction. In such a wave which propagate forming compressions and rarefactions, vibrations travel parallel to the direction of wave propagation. Such a wave is called longitudinal wave. So sound is called a wave. A wave is produced by a continuous disturbance in a medium. Mechanical waves. The waves that need a material medium to propagate are called mechanical waves. They are of two types, longitudinal and transverse waves. So sound is a mechanical wave because it has both longitudinal nature as well as transverse nature as a wave. Sound is a mechanical longitudinal wave in air. In transverse wave in a stretch string, particles of the medium vibrate about their mean position in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation of wave. Such waves travel in the form of crest and troughs. The transmission of mechanical transverse wave depends on the rigidity of the medium. So, these waves can be transmitted only through solids. They can be transmitted even through the surface of liquids. However, gases cannot transmit transverse waves. Some examples of transverse waves are waves on water surface and vibration in string. Graphical representation of a sound wave. When a sound wave moves forward through a medium, the medium at some places is in a state of compression and at other places in the state of rarefactions. Hence, the density of the medium oscillates between a maximum value and a minimum value. The change in the density from the maximum value again to the maximum value makes one complete oscillation.